فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. We're in our kitab ثلاثة الأصول لشيخ الإسلام محمد بن عبد الوهاب رحمه الله تعالى. Today inshallah ta'ala is going to be the third lesson inshallah ta'ala. We spoke about the statement of the author رحمه الله when he said الأولى العلم, that the first thing from the four things that is obligatory on every individual to come with is knowledge. We spoke about what knowledge is and the intent in which the Sheikh meant by al-ilm, and that he meant al-ilm al-shar'i, the Islamic knowledge. And we also spoke about the evidence that came regarding one seeking knowledge. Inshallah ta'ala, there is an important point that we need to speak about in this place, inshallah ta'ala, regarding knowledge. A person, as the scholars they say, blind following is not permissible when it comes to matters of aqeedah. What a person has to have knowledge. A person has to have the knowledge, meaning he has to have the evidence. وَالْوَاجِبُ فِيهِ أَنْ يُحَصِّلَهُ الْعَبْدُ أَنْ يَحْصُلَهُ الْعَبْدُ بِدَلِيلِهِ. It is obligatory on the person to gain knowledge in the usul and the aqeedah matters, such as Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and the religion of Islam. And that is why the scholars they say أَنَّ التَّقْلِيدَ لَا يَنْفَعُ فِي الْعَقَائِدِ. Blind following will not benefit you in aqeedah. بَلْ لَابُدَّ مِنْ مَعْرِفَةِ الْمَسَائِلِ الَّتِي يَجِبُ اعْتِقَادُهَا بِدَلِيلِهَا. Because it's obligatory for the person to know the matters which are obligatory on the person. It is obligatory on them to know it with their evidence. And the dalil here is more broader. وهذا الدليل أعم من أن يكون نصا من القرآن. The dalil that I'm referring to here is more broader than a textual evidence. نصا من القرآن, a textual evidence, a evidence from the Quran or من السنة or from the Sunnah or من قول صاحب or the statement of an individual or إجماع. So it's more than just a text from the Quran. It's more than a hadith from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It's more than a statement of a companion. It's more than an ijma' or even an analogy, a qiyas. And we're going to speak about that inshallah ta'ala in more details later. So according to Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah, التقليد لا يجوز في العقائد. Blind following is not permissible in aqeedah. Even the Asha'ira and the Maturidiyya, who are not from Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah, they also believe that as well. So according to these two deviated groups, Al-Asha'ira and Al-Maturidiyya, and also the Mutakallimin, they see لا يجوز التقليد, that blind following is not permissible. But there's a difference between Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah when they say blind following is not permissible in Aqeedah, and when the Asha'ir and the Maturidiyya, when they say it. And what is the difference between the two? The difference between the two is that the blind following according to Ahlul Sunnah is different from the blind following according to the Asha'ira and the Maturidiyya. والتقليد عند أهل السنة والجماعة يختلف عن التقليد عند أولئك. فأولئك يرون أن أول واجب هو النظر. Because the Asha'ira, they believe, and the Maturidiyya, they believe that the first thing that is needed from an individual is to look. Is to look. And they believe, فَلَا يَصِحُّ الْإِيمَانُ إِلَّا إِذَا نَظَرَ. They believe a person's iman is not correct unless he looks. And the look they mean here, as I said, وَيَقْصِدُونَ بِالنَّظَرِ النَّظَرُ فِي الْآيَاتِ الْمَرْئِيَّةِ فِي الْآيَاتِ الْكَوْنِيَةِ. They say that the person has to look at the universal signs. The person has to look at the heavens and he has to look at the earth. And from that he has to then try to say that Allah exists. And then from that, and etc. So the person has to have doubt before he comes with Islam, and then he has to remove that doubt of his by looking around. That is what the Asha'ira and the Maturidiyya believe. Amma Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, they say يجب أن يأخذ الحق بالدليل. They believe that is obligatory upon the person when the haq comes to them, they take it with his evidence. And the evidence, Ahlul Sunnah believe, is the textual evidence, such as the Quran, the Sunnah, the Ijma', etc. As for the Asha'ira and the Maturidiyya, what were they saying? They were saying, no, it has to be the universal signs. Whereas Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, they say it is necessary to look into the evidence. Not to extract from it, لَا لِأَجْلِ اسْتِنْبَاطِ. Not for the purpose to extract, but to know that evidence has come regarding this. Because not every person can do istinbat and extract a ruling. But the person needs to know that there is an evidence that has come regarding this issue. And what issues is it that a person is not allowed to blind follow? It is any matter which a person's Islam will not be correct except with it, such as a person knowing Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, that he is the one who deserves to be worshipped alone. A person has to have فَلَا بُدَّ أَن يَكُونَ عِنْدَهُ بُرْهَانٌ عَلَيْهِ. You have to have evidence for this, in which the person knows through the course of his life. And that is why the scholars, they teach this book in the masajid. And they make sure this book, Thalathatul Usul, is memorized and it's learnt. Especially those who are new to Islam, even those who are born into Islam, who don't know much about their religion, they also have to be taught this book. So they are well aware of the evidences that are needed from them in masail, these matters. So from the thing that a person has to have knowledge of, in which Sheikh Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab rahimahullah brought in his book, is ma'rifatullahi, that a person has to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That a person has to know Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And knowing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he exists. Also, the second is knowing Allah tabarak wa ta'ala in singling for him his rububiyyah. That Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is al-khaliq and al-raziq and al-mudabbir. He's the one who created you. He's the one who provides for you and the one who sustains your affairs and controls your affairs. That is number two. Number three is that you know Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is the one who is deserving of worship alone, and that no one should be worshipped besides Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the fourth is the person, he knows Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's names and attributes, and he affirms them for Him subhanahu wa ta'ala the way Allah tabarak wa ta'ala affirmed it for Himself, and the way that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam affirmed it for Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. And the person also negates from Allah tabarak wa ta'ala in his names and attributes. He negates from Him that which has come to him that Allah and His Messenger have negated. So that is what it means to know Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. It means to know His existence. It is also to know that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is rububiyyah. And rububiyyah means that Allah is khaliq and raziq and mudabbir. Number three is to know that Allah is the only one who deserves to be worshipped. And number four, which is to know Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's names and attributes. Also, knowing Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, one part of it is to know the textual evidences that have come regarding Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. So for instance, we know Allah tabarak wa ta'ala through the Quran. We know Allah tabarak wa ta'ala through the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We also, which is the ayat al-shar'iyyah, the textual evidences. The second way we also know Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is al-ayat al-kawniyyah, the universal signs that are around us. Inna fi khalqi as-samawati wal-ard wa ikhtilafi al-layli wan-nahari la-ayat. The day and the night, the morning, the evening, the earth and the heavens, all of them are signs for us to recognize Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And those ayat, which are the ayatul kawniyyah, the universal signs, if the person already has the ayatul shar'iyyah intact, the ayatul shar'iyyah, as I said, is the Quran, the kitab of Allah, and the sunnah of the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If he has that with him, and then the person moves on to looking at the universal signs, then that individual will be able to understand that Allah is the only one who deserves to be worshipped. And he will also believe there's going to be resurrection, and that the person will be rewarded in accordance to their actions. So that is ma'rifatullah, to know Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Then the Shaykh said, wa ma'rifatu nabiyyihi, to know the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And knowing the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is fardun ala kulli mukallafin. It is obligatory on every individual. And it is wa ahadu muhimmati ad-deen. And it is one of the most important things of our religion. The reason for that is our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, huwa al-muballighu anillahi ta'ala. He's the one who is conveying on behalf of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَهَذَا الْمَعْرِفَةِ تَسْتَلْزِمُ قَبُولِ مَا جَاءَ بِهِ مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى مِنَ الْهُدَى وَدِينِ الْحَقِّ. Knowing the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will necessitate, or it will entail, that the person accepts everything which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam comes with. From guidance and the true religion, the person will accept it, because they know the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And that is why it's important to know the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Then the Shaykh said, وَمَعْرِفَةُ دِينِ الْإِسْلَامِ بِالْأَدِلَّةِ, and to know the religion of Islam with evidence. ومعرفة دين الإسلام بالأدلة. To know the religion of Islam with evidence. الإسلام له معنيان. Islam has two meanings. معنى عام ومعنى خاص. Islam has a general meaning and it also has a specific meaning. لأنه قد وردت أدلة, because there has come evidence تدل على أن الإسلام خاص بهذه الأمة. There have come evidences that prove that Islam is specific to this nation. But there also have come evidences affirming Islam for the previous nations. Now let's look at the evidences that prove Islam as a general religion for all the previous nations as well. Surah Al-Ma'idah, ayah 54, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, Allah is talking about the Torah. And he's talking about the prophet of Banu Israel. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, يَحْكُمُ بِهَا النَّبِيُّونَ الَّذِينَ أَسْلَمُوا. So Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he described what? فَوَصَفَ اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ أَنْبِيَاءَ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ بِالْإِسْلَامِ. Allah described the prophets of Banu Israel with Islam. So that ayah shows that Islam is not specific to this nation alone. So this is the general Islam. Also Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he said in Surah Yunus, ayah 84, إن كنتم آمنتم بالله فعليه توكلوا إن كنتم مسلمين. When you look at the siyaq of the ayat, you realize Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is speaking about Nabiullah Musa saying this to his people. Allah said, إن كنتم آمنتم بالله, if you have believed in Allah, فعليه, only on Allah, توكلوا, rely on. إن كنتم مسلمين, if you are Muslims. Also Allah تبارك وتعالى said in Surah Al-Baqarah, ayah 133, he's talking about the children of Yaqub, أبناء يعقوب عليهم السلام. Allah said, قالوا نعبد إلهك وإله آبائك إبراهيم وإسماعيل وإسحاق إلها واحدا ونحن له مسلمون. They said, we will worship your Lord and the Lord of your fathers, Ibrahim and Ismail and Ishaq. Only one Lord we're going to worship. وَنَحْنُ لَهُ مُسْلِمُونَ. And we are Muslims. So that Islam is بِمَعْنَى الْعَامِ, the general meaning, or the general Islam. As for the specific Islam, it means the religion الدين الذي بعث الله نبيه محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم به. It is the religion which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he sent out Muhammad with. وجعله خاتمة الأديان. And Allah تبارك وتعالى, he made it the final religion. لا يقبل من أحد دين سواه, in which no religion will be accepted from anyone besides it. قال تعالى, Allah said, وَمَنْ يَبْتَغِ غَيْرَ الْإِسْلَامِ دِينًا فَلَنْ يُقْبَلَ مِنْهُ وَهُوَ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. سورة آل عمران, آية 85. Anyone who looks for a religion other than Islam, فَلَنْ يُقْبَلَ مِنْهُ, it will not be accepted from them. وَهُوَ, and that individual, فِي الْآخِرَةِ, in the hereafter, he is from those who are upon destruction and loss. In Surah Al-Ma'idah, ayah 3, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم وأتممت عليكم نعمتي ورضيت لكم الإسلام دينا. Today I have completed your religion unto you. And I have also completed my blessing unto you. And I have become pleased with Islam as a religion for you. Those two verses which I mentioned, they benefit us that Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, He is pleased for this ummah to be upon Islam. And the Islam that is being referred to here is بِمَعْنَ الْخَاصِ, the specific type of Islam, which is the Islam that our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came with. Imam Muslim narrated in his Sahih on the authority of Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَالَّذِي نَفْسُ مُحَمَّدٍ بِيَدِهِ, I swear by the Lord, in which Muhammad, his soul is in his hand. لَا يَسْمَعُ بِي أَحَدٌ مِّنْ هَذِهِ الْأُمَّةِ, no one hears me from this ummah. And the ummah here is ummatu da'wa, not ummatu al-ijaba. There's two types of ummah. The ummah who have accepted him, which are the Muslims only, and the ummatu al-ijaba, which means the disbelievers included. لا يسمع بي أحد من هذه الأمة يهودي ولا نصراني ثم يموت ولم يؤمن بالذي أرسلت به إلا كان من أصحاب النار. The Prophet said, I swear by the Lord in which my soul is in his hand. No one hears me from this ummah, whether he's a Jew or a Christian, whether he's a Jew or a Christian. And then he dies and he hasn't believed in that which I have been sent with, except that individual is from the people of the hellfire. The Shaykh said, Muhammad bin Abdul Wahab, Ma'rifatullahi, knowing Allah, ومعرفة نبيه, and knowing the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, ومعرفة دين الإسلام بالأدلة, and knowing the religion of Islam with evidence. What does he mean by أدلة? أدلة, first of all, it has come in a plural form. أدلة is plural. In the Arabic language, the plurals are three types. جمع مذكر السالم, a masculine plural, and a feminine plural. This is جمع أنث السالم, and the third one is a broken plural, which is جمع التكسير. The word أدلة, it came in the broken plural, جمع التكسير. The singular is دليل. And if you look at the singular, it has come in the morphological form of fa'il. And the wazn fa'il here is meant by fa'il. أي من الدلالة. دليل means هو المرشد إلى المطلوب, is that which guides you to the thing that you're looking for. Evidence is either إما سمعي وإما عقلي. A textual evidence or a logical evidence. The textual evidence is ما ثبت بالوحي من كتاب أو سنة. Is that which has been affirmed either from the Kitab of Allah and or the Sunnah of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. That is the textual evidence. As for the adilla aqli, is that which comes by way of observation and looking. ما ثبت بالنظر والتأمل. And we will be speaking about that. وسيأتي إن شاء الله تعالى شيء من ذلك في أثناء الرسالة. And we will be speaking about that more in details as we go into the book. Insha'Allah ta'ala, and we will be speaking about the issue of a taqleed in the issues of aqeedah properly. We will also be speaking about knowing Allah in more details. We'll also be speaking about knowing the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in more details. And we'll also be speaking about knowing the religion of Islam, what it means in more details. We will stop there for today's lesson, insha'Allah ta'ala. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أستغفرك وأتوب إليه.